I want to kick things off by talking about Lamar Jackson and the Baltimore Ravens. You know, the question everyone really wants to know is, can Lamar Jackson win a Super Bowl for the Baltimore Ravens organization when it's all said and done? You know, Lamar Jackson's a very polarizing player. There are some people out there that believe he's really, really good, and rightfully so, because he's been a very successful quarterback up to this point. But some people think that he deserves to be in the category with Aaron Rodgers, Tom Brady. Some Ravens fans have even told me he's better than Patrick Mahomes. And I disagree with those people. I think that those people are overrating Lamar Jackson a little bit. Not that Lamar Jackson's a bad quarterback. He's really, really good. But I don't think he's quite on the level of a Patrick Mahomes or Aaron Rodgers. Meanwhile, you have some people out there that just flat out refuse to give Lamar Jackson any type of credit. They always talk about how the coaching staff, the run game, the defense is the reason why the Ravens are winning. Some people out there think Lamar Jackson stinks, that he's overrated. And I've even had some people in the past tell me that they would rather have Sam Darnold over Lamar Jackson. Now, obviously, I think that those people would rather change their opinions now today, because that was several years ago. But several years ago, you heard some scouts, you know, even when Lamar Jackson was coming out of college, a lot of people had Sam Darnold rated over Lamar Jackson when Sam Darnold was coming out of USC and Lamar Jackson was coming out of Louisville. And, you know, I understood it, but I was never the biggest Sam Darnold fan. So, you know, some of those evaluators of talent have to eat crow. Here's the thing. I'm going to be the guy that brings a reasonable, objective opinion about Lamar Jackson, because that's what I do here on the show. I'm the guy that guides you to the right path regarding these opinions and these takes and evaluations on quarterbacks. So I'm going to give an honest and fair assessment about Lamar Jackson, okay? I'm not a Ravens fan, but I do think I can be fair right here, okay? I believe, based on what I've seen, Lamar Jackson is a legitimate long-term franchise quarterback. And not just a good, not just like an average quarterback. I think he's really, really good. And you can make the argument that right now, he's a great franchise quarterback. I could get behind that right away. In fact, I believe you can win a Super Bowl with Lamar Jackson as your starting quarterback. And quite frankly, over the next 5 to 10 years, I believe at some point, Lamar Jackson will lead the Baltimore Ravens to another Super Bowl championship win. I believe in Lamar Jackson, and I believe eventually, once his career is over with, he'll probably have a Super Bowl victory and a Super Bowl MVP next to his name. Like I said, I don't put Lamar Jackson in the category with Patrick Mahomes, Aaron Rodgers, Russell Wilson, Tom Brady, and even Deshaun Watson. Four of those quarterbacks have been to and won Super Bowls and have had much more postseason success. And while Deshaun Watson hasn't quite had the postseason success of a Tom Brady or a Russell Wilson, Deshaun Watson, to me, is just a guy that can carry a team and put them on his back. I understand he did not win a whole lot of games with the Houston Texans this past year, but I think he's a better pure passer than Lamar Jackson. And I think there's a little bit of an it factor to Deshaun Watson. Not saying Lamar doesn't have an it factor, but Deshaun Watson has not been blessed with being drafted to a well-run organization like Lamar Jackson, and he's putting up Lamar Jackson-type numbers. I think if you put a real team around Deshaun Watson, he's going to be really, he has a chance to become an all-time great quarterback. But if you were to tell me that you think that Lamar Jackson is better than Deshaun Watson today, I'm not going to be completely mad at you, because I think both are great quarterbacks. I really do. I think Lamar Jackson is not quite in a tier one quarterback yet, just because I'd like to see more postseason success. But I do think Lamar Jackson can get to that point. And when we look at these quarterbacks, outside of Mahomes, Rodgers, Wilson, Brady, and maybe Deshaun Watson, I think right now, today, I'd take Lamar Jackson over Josh Allen. Josh Allen's had one great season up to this point. A couple of years ago, Josh Allen threw more interceptions than touchdowns his rookie season. Lamar Jackson was lighting the world on fire his rookie season. He's been a much more consistent quarterback than Josh Allen up to this point. I need another year from Josh Allen. You look at Justin Herbert. Justin Herbert was excellent his rookie year. But when we talk about Lamar Jackson, Lamar Jackson's won over 70% of his games. We're talking about a league MVP right here. I think we'd be being prisoners of the moment if we put him if we put Justin Herbert over Lamar Jackson automatically right now, you look at Kyler Murray. I think Kyler Murray has a chance to become better than Lamar Jackson. Both are very similar players, but Kyler Murray hasn't even gotten his team to the playoffs yet. There's still a lot Kyler Murray has to prove. You look at Dak Prescott. Dak Prescott, over the past couple of years, you know, the past 2 to 3 seasons, his record versus teams above 500 is awful. He's not as talented as Lamar Jackson. Hasn't even been the MVP conversation, and let alone won a league MVP like Lamar Jackson. Dak hasn't been in the MVP conversation consistently. You look at Baker Mayfield, a guy that was in the same draft class as Lamar Jackson. You know, Baker Mayfield, I like Baker Mayfield, but are we forgetting that a year ago, Baker Mayfield looked awful when he was asked to put the Cleveland Browns on his back? I get it. Bad coaching staff, bad offensive line. But Lamar Jackson literally is the Baltimore Ravens offense. He is the run game. He is the dynamic passer that they need. If you take Lamar Jackson away from the Ravens, that offense totally changes. And the Cleveland Browns this past year became a run-first team. When Baker Mayfield threw the ball less, the Browns won more games. So, you know, let's pause with Baker Mayfield a little bit. You look at Carson Wentz a couple of years ago. Eagles fans were claiming that Carson Wentz was a better pure passer than Lamar Jackson. A lot of those guys are eating crow today. It's ironic because everyone thinks Lamar Jackson is going to get hurt, but Carson Wentz, the traditional pocket passer, is the one out here getting hurt. We're 3 years into Lamar Jackson's career, people. Okay? Lamar Jackson, 3 years in, has a 30-7 career record. 30 wins, 7 losses. And 3 of those 7 losses have been to Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs, who really, outside of Tampa Bay, no one has figured out how to slow down Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs consistently. The Tampa Bay Buccaneers did it in the Super Bowl, but everyone was pretty surprised about that. You know what I'm saying? You look at Lamar Jackson, great record so far, has a career pass rating over 100. He's won a league MVP up to this point. He's also led the league in touchdown passes. So for the people out there saying Lamar Jackson isn't a great passer, I wholeheartedly disagree. The statistics show he's a great passer. He led the league in touchdown passes a year ago. For a guy that's quote-unquote a running back or a run-first quarterback, how come he was able to lead the entire league in touchdown passes when Aaron Rodgers was healthy, Tom Brady was healthy, you know, Patrick Mahomes was playing? Out of all those guys, you know who was the number one quarterback as far as touchdown passes? The year Lamar Jackson won MVP was Lamar Jackson. Okay, not to mention, he rushed for over 1,000 yards. From a game plan standpoint, if I was a defensive coordinator, Lamar Jackson would keep me up at night and give me nightmares because he's the greatest and most explosive dynamic runner of the football at the quarterback position we've ever seen. And a lot of people say, oh, well, you have to throw the football to be a great quarterback. Quite frankly, as long as you're moving the chains, I really don't care, okay? And I think Lamar Jackson is here to stay with his running ability because you just can't stop that guy. He's just so dynamic and so explosive as far as running the football that no one up to this point really has been able to figure out how to stop Lamar Jackson. And we talk about, you know, him not being a precise passer. Well, for Lamar Jackson's career, he's completed 64% of his throws. Do you guys realize that Tom Brady, the greatest quarterback of all time, also has a career 64% completion percentage as far as his passes? Tom Brady, for his career, has completed 64% of his passes. And no one talks about how Tom Brady is not a precision passer or that he's not accurate. Meanwhile, Lamar Jackson has the same completion percentage for his career. I'm not a big stats guy, but I really don't understand the Lamar Jackson criticism. And every single year up to this point, Lamar Jackson and the Ravens have made the playoffs. And Lamar Jackson is still only 24 years old. The best version of Lamar Jackson has honestly yet to come. I think there's still a level that Lamar Jackson can tap into. I still believe there are some areas of his game he could get better in. I know people are going to say, well, Lamar Jackson, he hasn't played all that particularly well in the playoffs the last couple of years. I get it. But the first time he made the playoffs, it was his rookie season. And that was versus a very good Chargers defense led by Derwin James and Joey Bosa. The Ravens really didn't have a whole lot of weapons for Lamar Jackson to throw to. I'll give him a pass for that. Now, the next year versus Tennessee, you know, I get it. It was a bad home loss, but the Ravens defense could not stop Derrick Henry. And once again, the Baltimore Ravens did not have explosive wide receivers and weapons to help bail Lamar Jackson out. The Baltimore Ravens are great when they're playing up in front of people with a lead where they can run the football, play great defense, run play action with Lamar Jackson. That game, they got behind the eight ball, and the Titans spoiled their season. And then Lamar Jackson goes out there the very next year. This past year, wins a playoff game. He was excellent versus Tennessee, and then goes on the road versus Buffalo. And wide receivers were not getting open. They were dropping passes. The offensive line was not blocking. It was a very rainy day. Justin Tucker was missing field goals. It was going to be hard for any quarterback in that situation to thrive that day versus a very good Buffalo team. So I think that, look, you know, Peyton Manning struggled for the first couple of years to win playoff games. I think eventually Lamar Jackson is going to get it, okay? I think that eventually things will start to break his way in the playoffs. And the Baltimore Ravens organization, they value the offensive line. They value the run game. You know, the Ravens have always put a really good defense around Lamar Jackson. They've been good defensively for the past couple of years. Special teams, it matters to them. Having a great coaching staff. You know, you look at John Harbaugh. And the Baltimore Ravens finally went big on wide receiver this past offseason. Drafting Rashad Bateman. Drafting Taylor Wallace. Signing Sammy Watkins. They realized we got to get more dynamic. We have to be more dynamic than Kansas City and Buffalo. We have to put up some points. So they even went big on wide receiver. Okay, so, you know, I think that eventually the Ravens, things will break their way in the playoffs. And as long as they're in the dance every single year, they're going to have a puncher's chance, okay? When you look at Lamar Jackson, now that the Ravens have put better wide receivers around him, I think you're going to start to see him continue to play at a high level, you know? And Lamar Jackson has an incredible work ethic. He's the first guy in, last guy out, according to his coaches. He's got a really, you know, good fluid throwing motion. It's not like Cam Newton, where Cam Newton had this kind of, you know, awkward throwing motion. It always seemed like Cam Newton, you know, never really fixed his mechanics. You know, there's even today, Cam Newton's mechanics aren't all that great. I think Lamar Jackson is a more accurate quarterback than Cam Newton from an arm strength perspective, from a decision-making perspective, as far as Lamar Jackson's ability to process defenses quickly. He's got it all. And I know all of you are going to say, well, look at the flaws in his game. I'm sorry, people, but if you're looking for the perfect quarterback, that quarterback doesn't exist. Patrick Mahomes and Aaron Rodgers are the closest thing to a perfect quarterback, and even those guys have flaws. Okay, so I think Lamar Jackson's here to stay. And even if Lamar Jackson can't sustain the success that he's having for the next, you know, 15 to 17 years, if he can sustain this level of play for the next 5 to 7 years, and the Ravens win a Super Bowl, it's 100% worth it. And I think Lamar Jackson, the sky's the limit for him, and we'll see what happens going forward. But I believe that Lamar Jackson can win you a Super Bowl if he's your starting quarterback. Thank you so much for watching this video today. Please also note that the Juice Alert Sports Podcast is not just a YouTube channel. It is available on all podcasting platforms, including Spotify, Google Podcasts, iTunes, and Apple Podcasts. Also, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share this content with all your friends. This podcast is my favorite thing in the entire world right now. It is my passion. And I want more people to listen to this podcast. I really want this podcast to grow. Also, a fun fact about me is that I want to go into the sports broadcasting and media world once I graduate from the University of Toledo, a college in Northern Ohio. I am looking to become one of the next great sports broadcasters and analysts out in the world. And I potentially would like to start my own network if this podcast really, truly grows. Or if I fall short of that goal, I would love to work for a big-time network like ESPN or Fox Sports 1. I am open to all networks. So if you believe in my dreams and you see or hear my passion through the screen, be sure to tell all your friends about the Juice Alert Sports Podcast. Stay motivated, you guys. Have a God-blessed day, and I'm out.